सामान्य जनों के संगठित प्रयासों से असामान्य कार्य खड़ा करने वाले विवेकानंद शिला स्मारक विवेकानंद केंद्र को केंद्र की स्थापना करने वाले माननीय एकनाथ जी रानड़े, उनके विषय के बारे में हम सभी जानना चाहते हैं। विवेकानंद केंद्र के उपाध्यक्ष माननीय बालकृष्णन जी से नम्र अनुरोध है कि माननीय एकनाथ जी के जीवन के बारे में हम सभी को अवगत कराएं। माननीय बालकृष्णन जी,
रविवेड़ स्वामी गोविंद देव गिरी जी, रविवेड़ स्वामी चैतन्यानंद जी, रेस्पेक्टेड डॉक्टर लक्ष्मी कुमारी, रेस्पेक्टेड प्रेमनाथाई जी, एकनाथ जी जन्मशती समारोह समिति चेयरमैन श्री दीपक ठाकुर जी, जस्टिस सीवी रामलू जी, श्रद्धेय कृष्ण कुमार अस्सेना जी, डिस्टिंग्विश्ड इन्वाइटीज, परिवार बंधुस, केंद्र कार्यकर्ता, सिस्टर्स एंड ब्रदर्स, ऑन द ओकेशन ऑफ द इनॉग्रेशन ऑफ द जन्मशती पर्व ऑफ स्वर्गीय एकनाथ जी रानड़े, द स्पिरिट बिहाइंड द विवेकानंद रॉक मेमोरियल एंड विवेकानंद केंद्र कन्याकुमारी, आई ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ केंद्र ऑफर अवर हार्टिएस्ट प्रणाम्स टू ऑल द लीडिंग एनलाइटेंड leading and enlightened personalities assembled in this Vigyan Bhavan auditorium. Sisters and brothers, it is needless to stress here that many of you in the audience had occasion to work with Eknaiji while he was a Sangha Adhikari or when he had taken up the work of construction of Vivekananda Rock Memorial at Kanyakumari. I have been asked to say a few words about my association and experience while working with him. I consider it a great honor that I have worked under him for 9 years. Eknaiji was a multifaceted personality, and it is very difficult to say which facet of his life was more bright and colorful. But it was a life full of challenges and achievements. Belonging to a very humble family, facing all problems and hardships from the childhood days, he rose to extraordinary heights. His life was an example of high dedication. Right from the college life, he became a full-time RSS Pracharak and continued so till his last breath. It was a life of dedication personified. Eknaiji was a visionary of highest order, a Dirghadarshi. During 1950, when there was an earthquake of very high intensity in the northeast region of India, and the river Brahmaputra changed its course, resulting in most parts of Assam and nearby areas being inundated under floodwaters, causing extensive damage, loss of property. Eknaiji, as a Purvanchal Pracharak of the RSS, had organized massive relief work in those areas. During that time, Parampoojaniya Guruji Golwalkar, who was the Sarsanghchalak, visited that area along with Eknaiji to have a first-hand report of the colossal loss of life and property. At that time, Eknaiji had apprised Guruji that the entire northeast region is a melting pot and needs immediate attention. He told Guruji that anti-national forces are working freely and openly to deface the cultural mosaic of Assam and other indigenous faces of northeast areas. He stressed upon Guruji to spread that networking of RSS in those far-flung areas. How a truthful Eknaiji's assessment of the Northeast 65 years ago, it is all visible today. Eknaiji was a man of high commitment and obedience. When Parampoojaniya Guruji entrusted him with the work of Vivekananda Rock Memorial, he readily accepted it, even though he never had experience of constructing any memorial or mandir in the past. For Eknaiji, it was an ajna, the obedience to the hierarchy, and it was to be followed implicitly. His obedience was remarkable. His commitment for the given cause was unquestionable. Eknaiji was a good strategist. When he took up the work of Vivekananda Rock Memorial, he had to confront with many problems from various sources. With a cool head and boldness, he prioritized the work. He handled the situation very effectively and firmly while dealing with the Professor Humayun Kamir, the then tourism minister, who opposed the very idea of Vivekananda Rock Memorial in Kanyakumari tooth and nail. Ekanaji humbled him shrewdly, and Professor Kabir had to withdraw his opposition. Similarly, he brought all those who were opposing the Vivekananda Rock Memorial in Kanyakumari by persuasion and reconciliation to his side. Even the obstinate Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Sri M. Bhaktavalsalam, who said that Vivekananda Rock Memorial in the Mid-Sea would never be allowed during his lifetime, had to change his views and toe the line as suggested by Ekanaji. Sri Bhaktavalsalam became an ardent supporter of Vivekananda Rock Memorial later. The credit goes to Ekanaji's style of handling people occupying even in high position. Ekanaji was a man who believed in hot pursuit. He never left anything for chances or resorted to casual approach. When late Sri Lal Bahadur Shastri asked Ekanaji to prepare a memorandum for submitting to Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru to get his consent for the construction of Vivekananda Rock Memorial at Kanyakumari, duly signed by as many MPs as possible, Ekanaji immediately plunged in the task of getting the signatures of members of parliament belonging to different political ideologies. His ability for hot pursuit and his persuasive capacity enabled him to get the signatures of 323 members of parliament within 3 days, fully supporting the need for a befitting memorial to Swami Vivekananda in the Mid-Sea at Kanyakumari. This act of Ekanaji exhibited high commitment to the given task and his ability to persuade all sections of the people, irrespective of what political color they carried. As a master organizer, Ekanaji very capably galvanized a team of highly dedicated and competent people for the erection of Vivekananda Rock Memorial in quick time. The most difficult task undertaken by Ekanaji in his lifetime found fruition in a record time of 6 years. He evolved a very unique fundraising program whereby he could reach out even to the common man who also contributed ₹1 and had the fulfillment of owning the great memorial. 30 lakhs of people contributed ₹80 lakhs and made it a truly national monument. Central and state governments, industrialists and businessmen also contributed for this national cause without any reservation. Ekanaji was highly inspired by Swami Vivekananda's life and message. As a college student, he studied Swamiji's life and got himself fully saturated with his patriotism and love for Bharatiya Sanskriti. As Swami Vivekananda was the sheet anchor for the Indian freedom movement, Ekanaji was always of the view that the great Swamiji's message of love for Bharat should be preached to the younger generation, out of whom the new workers will come out like young lions. He therefore, after the construction of Vivekananda Rock Memorial, immediately engaged himself to spread the message of Swami Vivekananda to the nook and corner of India. His oft-quoted words are, to quote, "Vivekananda Rock Memorial is only a monument in granite stone to perpetuate Swamiji's historic meditation on the rock. Whereas the Vivekananda Kendra, a spiritually oriented service mission, is a memorial in flesh and blood to carry his message to the younger generation. Therefore, Ekanaji started training and deploying young men and women as Jeevanvrittis, missionaries, to devote themselves in service activities and thereby carry the message of selfless service and potential divinity of man as preached by great Swami Vivekananda. As envisioned earlier, he felt that the country's northeastern region needs prompt and careful attention. Therefore, he gave priority for that area and deputed a team of Jeevanvrittis to Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, etc. Ekanaji direction to the young Jeevanvrittis who were deputed northeast region was very clear and straightforward. The people living in those far-flung hilly areas should develop love for the country, and therefore their patriotic fervor should be triggered. Giving formal education by setting up a chain of schools in the northeast region border areas to give man-making and character-building education was the need of the hour. Kendra, within a decade, could set up a number of such education institutions in Assam, Arunachal Pradesh and Nagaland. Intensive and extensive rural development programs along with the health and hygiene work in the interior tribal areas have created a congenial atmosphere for Kendra work. While taking up all these service activities, Ekanaiji gave a very free hand and timely encouragement to the Kendra workers. Veganda Kendra fulfilled the dream of Ekanaiji by setting up an institute of culture in Guwahati, Assam, to cater the needs of the northeastern states. Another dream of Ekanaiji was fulfilled when Kendra set up the Vivekananda International Foundation in Delhi in 2009 as an independent and non-partisan institution that promotes quality research and offers a platform for dialogue and conflict resolution. Few of the programs as dreamt by Ekanaiji, which are yet to be given practical shape, are: one, setting up 12 zonal centers for the training of dedicated workers, setting up a research on Yoga Vedanta of international standard in Kanyakumari, setting up model education institutions for girls in all the districts of India. We are sure, by the blessings of the Almighty Goddess Kanyakumari, Kendra will be able to fulfill all the dream projects of Ekanaiji as early as possible. With these words, I conclude by thanking all of you once again. Vande Mataram.